This is Langy TV. My name is Liam Bentley and this is the Midweek Roundup. And let's have a look at the scores around the grounds from this week's Round 7 action of the Gammies State League 1 South East. First of all, of course, there was a 5-2 win for the Langy boys away to Caulfield Cobras. We also had a 4-0 win for Mornington over Warrego United. A surprise 2-1 win at home for Moorabark against Morwell Pegasus. Manningham United, this week's opponents, lost 1-0 to St Kilda in a tight match there. FC Clifton Hill got the better of KC Comets with a 3-0 victory. And a draw, a 1-0 draw was the result between South Springvale and Malvern City. And of course that leads us to this week, and we know what's happening down at Lawton Park this weekend, but around the grounds again, so KC Comets versus Moorabark if you fancy your Friday night fix down at Comet Stadium. Mornington have a huge match against Caulfield United Cobras, St Kilda against Clifton Hill, Malvern United are hosting Warrego United, and Morwell Pegasus will be hosting South Springvale. So make sure you catch all the action here next week. Gus, magnificent win against Caulfield United Cobras on the weekend. How did you see that game?
Yeah, I was very pleased. Obviously, they've not conceded many goals, and to get away from home and win 5-2, it's a good achievement with the boys.
That puts you 4 points clear at the top of the league now. A handy little lead, albeit early in the season.
Oh, very early. You know, there's a lot of people getting carried away. I'm certainly not getting carried away. And if you look at our next three fixtures, we only look at the next week, but the next three fixtures are very, very important to the club. You know, we've got Manningham at home, who I watched against KC Comets a week last Friday night, and I was very, very impressed with them. They were a very fit, organised side, and we're in for a tough game on Saturday, you know, and then we go away to Mornington and away to Clifton Hill. So I think the next 3 weeks will test the lads.
Also, a few boys down at the pool tonight, nursing a couple of slight injuries. Anything to worry about for the Langy fans?
Not really. It's more a precautionary, Liam, and it's like everything else. If you just give them a wee bit of time to recover, you know, we could have them training tonight and then something goes wrong, you know, and you say to yourself, I shouldn't have done that. But it's just precautionary, and the boys have worked quite hard, and any knocks that they're getting, then down at the pool, Peter Tuckett's got them down there, so they'll do a good recovery session down there, and then we'll sharpen up for Thursday, see who's everybody's fit, and the headache continues of who to play and whatever.
And how do you see this week's match shaping up? What kind of match are we expecting?
Well, I can honestly say that when I watched them against Casey, as I say, they came out from the very first minute and they never stopped working. They were very mobile, very organised. Their midfield three and their front three just kept alternating, moving into space, which caused Casey a little bit of a problem. There was a wee guy, a wee blonde guy, 14 I think he was, and he was very, very mobile. You know, 1 minute he was in the middle of the park, next minute he was up front, and I think it caused a wee bit of confusion to the Casey defence. So that's something we've got to watch, and but the other thing is they've got to watch what we're doing, and when you get players that can score goals the way we're scoring them at the moment, then we don't have to worry too much about the opposition. It's ourselves. And last week, everybody, I thought, had a reasonable game, and I think that makes a difference. If you've got 11 players playing reasonable games, then you're going to do okay.
All right, obviously Liam scored two cracking goals in the weekend. He's one of the guys down at the pool in the recovery session. Who else have we got down there tonight?
We've got Axie, the goalkeeper. He's getting on a bit, so it's that's his excuse. Yaya. We've got Kieran down there, who's just come back for the UK with a quad injury. He's recovering. Connor Belger. Who else is down there? Johnny Guthrie. To be honest, the squad's, you know, it's looking good, but at the same time, we've got to be careful with them. And as I say, with Axie and the likes of Yaya, they're no young boys anymore, so we just got to look after them.
Just recently, we caught up with the first team squad and asked them a few questions about the dressing room, their pre-match and their post-match, and here's some of what they had to say. Where's the post-match night out?
Yo-yo.
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 Ah, it's got to be Yo-Yo with Yaya.
Where the better?
Yo-Yo with Yaya.
Yo-Yo with Big Yaya and his crew.
Pete Tuckett's guest list at Love Machine on a Sunday.
Yo-Yo.
I'm so glad you said that because everybody else said yeah? Yo-Yo's with Yaya.
Who's the coach's pet?
Alex.
Speedy.
Speedy.
Maka.
Speedy.
Alex.
Aaron.
Belger.
Probably Andy, maybe.
Disguises.
Buzz.
So, a few of the new boys are working with Greg Kilner at one of our major sponsors, Premier Builders. He also does cut about the pitch on the odd training night as well. But let's have a look back at Greg Kilner and his Langy heydays.
In 2000, he put the icing on the cake with his cracker against Seaford in a championship game. In 2002, who could forget the winner against Kingston in injury time? And in 2003, the winner against Strikers that put Langy into the playoffs.
Team who's been with us for the 7 years is Greg Kilner. Greg's played some like 230 odd games, scored 101 goals. I personally would like to say, Greg, for the last 7 years it's been fucking tremendous working with you. You will lead the team out today, you will be the skipper as far as I'm concerned.
In the last game of the season 2005, and in recognition for his loyalty and his contribution to the club, Kilner was given the captain's armband for the game against Westvale. The boys ran out 4-0 winners on that day, and although he didn't get on the score sheet, his hard work was as evident as ever. The last 10 years has been a rollercoaster ride for Greg Kilner, but I bet if you asked him, he'll tell you he loved every minute of it. Congratulations, Greg. Thanks for the memories.
Oh, no, not me. I did it my way. For what is a man? What has he got, if not himself, then he has not to say the things he truly feels, and not the words of one who kneels. The record shows I took the blow.
That's all I've got time for this week on Langy TV. Don't forget to get down to Lawton Park this Saturday for big game against Manningham United Blues. And unfortunately, due to previous filming commitments, we won't be able to live stream or provide highlights for this week's coming match. So you better get down there and support the boys on the day. Thanks for watching.